Australian frogs, they need our help. And you can do that by checking out the noises that they make, but maybe it's not quite like this.
Hello, my baby. Hello, my honey. Hello, my ragtime gal. Send me a kiss by wire. Baby, my heart's on fire. If you refuse me, honey, you'll lose me. Then you'll be left alone. Oh, baby, telephone and tell me I'm your own.
No, 40 Australian frog species are threatened with extinction, can you believe, at the moment. And with your phone, you can help save them. And to tell us more, we're joined by lead scientist for FrogID, Dr. Jodi. And she's here with a little friend. So nice to see you, Dr. Jodi. And who's your mate?
This is Kermit. This is an Australian green tree frog.
That's an original name. Many Kermits in your community?
Yes, it is quite a popular name, and it's now thinking of jumping on my face, so this could be fun.
Is she saying, like, you know what?
Well, she calmed down during that song, so maybe,
And Kermit's a girl.
Kermit is a girl, but this species doesn't have quite such a beautiful call as many species, so you're probably familiar with the green tree frog call. It's like... So this is, every species of frog has a different call, and this is the green tree frog call.
Okay. Hey, tell us, why are these frogs being threatened with extinction? That's so sad.
Sort of by a whole bunch of things. Habitat loss and modification, climate change, pollution, introduced species, and unfortunately disease. Ooh. So frogs have been dealing with their own pandemic for several decades. There's something called chytridiomycosis. It's a type of fungus that affects their skin, and because the skin of the frog, they drink through their skin, they breathe in part through their skin. Unfortunately, it's caused a lot of problems and is probably the main reason that we've lost at least four species of frog in Australia. And a lot of them are still sort of battling this with this pandemic. And so now we've got a lot more experience with pandemics. We can, I guess, empathise a lot with frogs, but frogs don't do social distancing. So it has been really affecting them, especially in winter when their immune systems kind of go down. Mm. We've seen a lot of frogs dying, unfortunately.
Oh, bless you. So you're doing your part to try and... eradicate. Get in. How good is that? That was awesome. Do you know, I was panicking that Kermit was going to do that to me. I'm so happy it happened to you.
Are you okay? That was amazing, though. That was amazing.
No, I'm used to frogs jumping on my face.
Okay. It's all good.
Kermit, she's here to help. Tell us about Frog ID Week.
So it starts today, and it's all based upon the fact that every species has a different call. So all you need to do is download the free Frog ID app, press record whenever you hear frogs calling as much as possible until the 20th. It goes all the time, but this is when we want that really good understanding of where our frogs are and how they're doing. So anytime you hear a frog, local creek, pond, anything like that, just record him every day. She's thinking of making another leap for the face. And you can help us better understand and conserve frogs. So that's one of the biggest challenges, is that we just need more information on where our frogs are and how they're doing, and you can help.
You did a great impression of the green tree frog at the start of the interview, but we want to play you this sound. Just have a listen to this. Now, that's not Tristan after
food. That was a dog.
What sort of frog is making that sound?
It's a sandhill frog.
Oh.
So a lot of people think that frogs, you know, do go croak or ribbit, but it's absolutely insane, the different kind of noises that Australia's frogs make. And that squelchy noise is the call of the sandhill frog from Western Australia. And that, until recently, the call was unknown to science. So
they'll just
really
all blame
exciting.
It on the dog in WA. They're like, not me. It wasn't me. I smelled a delta.
There's a sign somewhere going, it was that frog, I think, yeah. Now, last year, Australian bird calls topped Ed Sheeran and Adele in the ARIA charts. What's the goal this year?
Oh, well, so we've got the Sounds of Disappearance album coming out, and we do hope that it's going to top the charts, because, of course, frogs are way better than birds. But in Frog ID Week as well, we're just really hoping that we can get as many recordings as possible. Last year, we had a day that had an average of 4 records of frogs per minute during Frog ID Week. So let's top that this year. It's wet throughout a lot of Australia, so the frogs should be croaking. And so, yeah, we're hoping to actually... get lots more ribbits, croaks, hoots and squelchy noises from across Australia.
It's quite amazing. In fact, since the project began, you've had over 700,000 frog call records. So how important has that been to your team and to science?
Oh, incredible. It's been an absolute game changer. You know, I didn't know how much people cared about frogs. So yeah. I guess in addition to the data that we're getting that's helping us understand what species need our help, what places are most important, you know, we're understanding how frogs are being impacted by urbanisation, the effect of the black summer bushfires, the droughts, the floods. You know, it's actually, you know, when we couldn't get out in the field because of lockdown, so our scientists couldn't figure out what was going on after the fires, everybody was out there recording with FrogID. So it's been... absolutely amazing, yeah, and a game changer for frogs. Also, just connecting people to frogs. You know, people don't realise that that sort of bopping noise or that squelchy noise in their backyard is actually a frog. And when you sort of realise what amazing creatures that we're lucky enough to share Australia with, hopefully, you know, there's now a frog army that cares about their local frogs and conservation and is working to help save frogs.
Oh, that's awesome. You have such a lovely passion as well for frogs, Dr. Jodi. Thanks so much for chatting with us. FrogID Week, it starts on Monday. You can download the app and record some frog calls. Should you kiss a frog if you see one?
Better leave it alone, yeah, but they might want to kiss you.
There you go, yeah. Just don't lick one. Yeah. Dr. Jodi, thanks so much for joining us today.
Thanks, Dr. Jodi.
And Kermit.
Thanks, Kermit.
Thank you.
Jump away.